Bis. So both chords are the same voicing here. This is in D minor. So let's take a look at this chord voicing applied to a C minor 7 chord. In our left hand, we're going to play the root and the fourth. And then in our right hand, we're going to play the minor 7th, the minor 3rd, and then on top, we're going to add the 5th of the chord, which is G. And this is our voicing. And it's just a stack of fourths up from the root, but then with a major 3rd on top. And it would be perfect for any time you see a minor 7 chord in the chord sheet and the melody note is the 5th. This would be a great chord voicing to play. And you can do all sorts of things with this chord voicing. It sounds very good if you go around side slipping it, basically moving it in parallel. I'm just transposing the same voicing. In fact, that's what Bill Evans does in So What. He plays an E minor 7, going to D minor 7, and he uses the same voicing. And that would be a great way to ingrain this voicing, would be to just do some side slipping, where you just build the same voicing pattern from different root notes and move this voicing up and down by half steps and whole steps. So block chords are another type of voicing that jazz piano players can play. They have a very nice and dated sound. So there's different voicing patterns that you can use for block chords, but one of my favourite ways just to start simply is just to enclose each chord voicing in an octave. So let's say you had a C minor 7 chord and the melody note was the 9th, which is a D. Well, you would start by doubling the D down an octave, and then you just want to contain the rest of the chord voicing between these two notes. So that just means you want to get as many of the chordal tones and to fit them in between this octave. Chordal tones are just the root, 3rd, 5th, and 7th of whatever chord it is. So I might play this, and I could squeeze in the C as well, but it's actually a good principle to give a bit of space to the melody note. So you don't really want a whole step below. It just makes it hard for the ear to spot the melody note. So I might skip out the C for this one and just play the 3rd, the 5th, and the 7th enclosed in the 9th. And then when the melody note changes, you change the bottom octave with it. And then you're just trying to fill in as many of the chordal tones within that octave. Okay, so let's take a look at a really nice chord voicing. Now this is for a C7 sus4. So let's just take a look at this chord without the voicing. This would be C dominant 7 sus4. It's basically when you take a C dominant 7 chord, but instead of playing the major 3rd, you shift the 3rd up and play the 4th instead. This is the suspended 4th, that's why it's called a sus4. So this is a modification you can do to dominant 7 chords. But now let's take a look at the voicing. It's quite a simple voicing. We're just going to play the root in our left hand, that's C, and in our right hand, we're going to play a B flat major triad. Now, as with most jazz chords, it doesn't sound amazing on its own, but when you put it in context, it does. So this is a dominant 7 chord. Dominant 7 chords like to resolve down a 5th, either to an F major 7 chord or an F minor 7 chord. So I'm demonstrating this sus chord built from C. So it's going to resolve down to either of these. Now I call this the Horace Silver sus4 chord. Why? Well, Horace Silver uses this voicing in his song, Song for My Father. There's this lovely bit at the end of each line pretty much. So the music is in F minor, makes its way down to this dominant chord, C dominant 7, and he plays C in the root, and then in the right hand, you just play a B flat major triad, and it resolves really nicely to F minor 9. You get really nice voice leading here. If you go to an A flat major 7 chord, which is the voicing he uses for the F minor 9 chord, all of these voices just go outwards. Now, if you want more exotic jazz piano sounds, well, I've put together a free piece of sheet music which goes into even more exotic jazz piano sounds. You can download that for free at the link below.